All right, so Taji, are you ready to do this?
Might have seen previously, I attended a strip club featuring women performers.
Man, what has your experience been like working here?
Yeah, we're all armed. You know, we're ready for war. The next coming civil war happens between us and all the Muslims.
Was a hell of a time. But, you know, I like to keep my options open, like to broaden my horizons. So today, the male strip club. The word male hasn't been canceled yet, has it? I am a male, so I can probably get away with saying it, at least. Male. All right, so I've just stumbled upon Le Bear. Appears to be a place of many men that strip.
They weren't very interactive, and truthfully, they seemed pretty bored.
This is the worst strip club I've ever been to, male or female. Looked bored and zero fun.
I noticed several times that many of the men were not smiling and did not look very excited.
Paid $20 for a 40-second lap dance.
40 seconds does seem pretty quick for a lap dance. I got one at the last strip club and it probably lasted. I mean, I was like, it was almost too long.
Well, if you are male, gay, straight, pansexual, whatever your sexual orientation, it's $70 to get in. And you have to sit at the bar.
I think in order to fully understand these reviews, it makes the most sense to go undercover. First ever exclusive undercover one-star reviews.
The only way to really get to the bottom of these reviews was to infiltrate. There was no way I could do a proper analysis by sitting at the bar, and I certainly did not have $70 to spare. I was going to go undercover, posing as someone looking to get into the erotic dancing profession, and Le Bear had offered me the chance to learn the ropes and audition with a performance in front of a live crowd.
Hello.
Hello. Hi, very you? Nice to meet you. I'm manager. My name is Gino.
So nice to meet you,
nice
Gino.
Nice to meet you, too.
My name is Taji.
Nice to meet you, Taji. So you're thinking about entertaining?
Yes, I kind of just wanted to come in and just get a feel for it and see if I, you know, have what it takes to dance.
Have you done it before?
I have never done this before, no.
Oh, nice.
After a short tour of the establishment, Gino broke down what to expect during my audition.
Going to go up on stage to try out. It's a small little performance to see if you have the job or not. You'll probably be up here for about 4 or 5 minutes just to see if you have rhythm and if you have what it takes to work here at Le Bear.
I was feeling quite nervous about the thought of getting up on stage, but I couldn't show it. I couldn't break my cool and confident exterior if I was going to get to the bottom of these one-star reviews. Gino took me to the underwear department to make my selection.
These are the briefs that the guys wear.
That's kind of a nice, like, kind of shiny one.
This is an all-white one.
Does the white one look pretty cool with the
lights? Yeah, with
lights,
the lights, especially with the black lights, they look really nice.
Camo, red. It's pretty cool, red ones.
Yeah.
Awesome, is there kind of a leopard thing going on?
Nice. You can pick whichever one you like.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And then from there, we'll go up on stage and see if you have what it takes to work here at Le Bear.
Upon closer inspection of their underwear, it was clear that they used a network of size-enhancing reinforcements, which would make it appear as if their packages were larger than they actually were.
You just kind of just put them right on like normal underwear?
Yep.
You kind of just tuck in here, I guess? Just.
Yep, you just...
Right on. Cool.
More of a silhouette type of thing.
Right on.
So if they were stretching the truth about their size, it got me wondering if there might be any truth to the reviews I'd seen online.
They weren't very interactive, and truthfully, they seemed pretty bored.
The guys were snobby and rude.
Poor routine.
My dance partner, mentor, and potential future colleague, Valentino, had arrived. It was a nice chance to get acquainted before starting rehearsals.
Kind of like pick up the light, really cool. Thank you.
The light,
totally. Thank you.
Other way around.
Oh, other way around.
There
got
you
it.
Go.
Cool.
There you go.
Alrighty.
I was then introduced to our fellow dancer Lorenzo and learned about their special connection.
He's my cousin from Italy. He's like, we're on vacation in Capri? No.
Yeah, in Capri. He told me that he was working here as a stripper and it was okay. I'm going to buy the ticket for the flight, and I'm coming.
After taking a moment to get to know each other, it was time to learn the choreography of the routine.
Every move you make, just make it dramatic.
Okay.
Cool. Okay. Boom. Boom. You turn around. Right here. Right here. I need a big swing. Big swing. Big swing. Okay. And then explode right here.
The routine was more challenging than I had imagined, but it would not distract me from my mission. Although it did have me concerned that I would be performing this in front of a live audience in just 1 hour.
Other way, face it. Make sure you face the crowd when you're doing that. There you go.
So like this?
Yeah.
Being on the inside, it seemed to me that so far the dancers were really putting in maximum effort into their routines. I was under their spell, but I had to keep my mind on the reviews.
Drop. Yeah, lock and drop. Nice, okay. Again, one more time.
I hadn't much time to rehearse, but this was my audition, and I was committed.
I see, like, all these girls just showed up. It's kind of crazy.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I mean, a whole, like, early now, a whole, like, escalade of women just arrived.
It's Fridays and Saturdays. It's very good.
So they picked a pretty good night, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
I was nervous to see the crowds roll in, but if this is what it takes to get to the bottom of LeBaire's one-star reviews, then I would get the job done.
Let's see if he gets the routine. If he does, he'll be working here at LeBaire.
All right.
Thank you.
All right.
The guys took me through their pre-show rituals, and it slowly dawned on me just how much effort goes on behind the scenes. These guys were no amateurs, but pros pumping up before game time. And Gino was our coach.
All right, guys, are you guys ready to go up on stage?
We're ready.
All right, Todd, let's see what you got. Just go out there, have fun, put a smile on your face, and you'll be fine, all right? Good luck, man.
Thank you, Gino.
I wish you the best. Let's try to make this.
Come Thank on. You so much.
Let's do it. You're Thank welcome. You.
Moments away from the show, I realized if I botched the routine, I would easily be the reason for a new flurry of one-star reviews.
This is the worst strip club I've ever been to.
Poor routine. Routine.
Was my undercover operation a big contradiction? Was I going to become a one-star review myself? I could not let that happen, so I took a moment to reflect on my conversation with Valentino.
Are you ever nervous, or is that something you had to overcome?
You overcome it. It's like riding a bicycle. Do you overcome that fear?
How many girls can handle more than one man at once? How many girls want to take three men on at once?
There was no turning back.
Somebody make some noise for me, Lorenzo. You ready for more? Somebody make some noise for Tasha. Somebody scream for Valentino. Get ready, because they all have great, big, huge, wide open arms just for you. Let's give it up out there for those gentlemen. Now I gotta know how many girls want to bring them back out tonight.
Eight. Nice.
We did it. The guys took me under their wing and it felt amazing. And while my adrenaline was high, I felt like it was the perfect time to ask Gino about their one-star reviews.
Before I came here, you know, I checked out the Yelp and I saw, you know, people were writing certain things. Like someone even wrote like, you know, these guys look like, you know, they're not having fun, they're bored, this, that.
This is the worst strip club I've ever been to.
Truthfully, they seemed pretty bored.
The guys were snobby and rude.
You know, there's always gonna be good and bad reviews. Most of the girls that do come here, they always usually have a good time and they usually leave good reviews. And then you have the sour ones that really don't wanna really have too much fun and they're new to this. And they're a little awkward in here.
Paid $20 for a 40-second lap dance.
One person even claimed like something about like the pricing is strange. Like they said that like they got, I guess, like a 40-second lap dance for $20 or something. Is that like...
Right, it's normally about 2 to 3 minutes for a table dance. You know, girls are always gonna want a little more extra.
Well, if you are male, gay, straight, pansexual, whatever your sexual orientation, it's $70 to get in, and you have to sit at the bar.
I guess a lot of guys were writing reviews, and like they seemed like almost unhappy sometimes with their experience, saying coming as like a single guy, it's like kind of like
right.
Different they, situation.
They have to be accompanied by a woman, and when they do come in, they would have to sit at the VIP or at the bar. That's the only place they're allowed to sit, just because it's a lady-friendly club and it's all about the ladies.
And how do they deal with people critiquing the actual performance? Like someone was writing like, oh, like, you know, it's a poor routine.
Right. Most of these guys, you know, we hire new guys. We hire guys with no experience. So we always give everybody a chance as long as they look good, their bodies fit, and they have a good personality. And they, of course, have to have dance moves, too.
I can tell. So, no, I mean, they seem to put all their heart in it.
Oh, like, yeah. It's a really good feeling. Once you get the job, you'll know.
After a successful undercover operation, it was time to leave. And I wanted to thank Gino for the opportunity of a lifetime.
Just keep working out, tan a little bit, come in early to practice. But I have some good news to tell you. You got the job. I need you to come in on Sunday. Great job. Come in Sunday at about 7 o'clock.
I went to Le Bear with the expectation of bored and snobby models performing poorly executed routines. However, I was instantly brought in with open arms by a heroic army of men. These men channel the energy of the crowd and fearlessly put it straight into their act, some of who have demonstrated such commitment to their performance that they have even moved all the way from Italy for the opportunity. I myself even managed to get up on stage to experience it firsthand, and I have to say, it was the adrenaline rush of a lifetime to be in front of so many wonderful and supportive women. And there's nothing boring about that. It may not be for everyone, because not all people go in there with the same expectation, but if you are someone who likes a night out with the girls to appreciate some prime physique and explosive dancing, then this is the place for you. Thank you, Le Bear. 5 stars for you. And what's your favorite thing about dancing?
I love performing. I love like putting a smile on the girl's face.
On the girl's face?
Yeah. I love...
That's the first thing.
Yeah.
And you guys are probably like pretty stoked when you're doing it too, it seems.
That's all we're about.
Totally.
Yeah.